أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله، اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم، وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. ثم أما بعد، ما زلنا في رحلتنا المباركة مع الصلاح والإصلاح، وقلنا أن صلاح الذات أو النفس البشرية تحتاج إلى صلاح العقل والقلب. قلنا العقل يأتي عن طريق العلم وتصحيح مفهوم العقيدة، العبادات، المعاملات. We talk about the صلاح and إصلاح, and we said to fix ourselves and to reform ourselves, we have to know about our عقيدة, our عبادات, our معاملات, and fix all of them. And we agreed that we will have one hour every week where we learn our deen, so our عقل will get the علم and knowledge. Okay. And we talked number two about the قلب. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول في الحديث: ألا إن في الجسد مضغة إذا صلحت صلح الجسد كله، وإذا فسدت فسد الجسد كله، ألا وهي القلب. In the heart there is an organ. If it's fixed and good, the whole body will be good. And if it's bad, the whole body will be bad. It is the heart. So we said we need to fix and reform our heart starting from this Ramadan, inshallah. وقلنا ان اول شيء يصلح القلب بزياده الايمان هو الايه؟ قراءه القران. يعني we have to number one, we have to connect ourselves with the Quran by reciting, by understanding, by implementing. So the Quran has to be done on different levels. والامر الثاني في اصلاح القلب, the second point for fixing our heart is ذكر الله سبحانه وتعالى. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في القرآن: الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى in the Holy Quran said that those who remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى and all the time Allah سبحانه وتعالى in their mind, their hearts will be assured, their hearts will have this tranquility because by the remembrance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى تطمئن القلوب. You have this feeling of assurance and the good feeling in the heart when you remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى. طبعا الذكر هو ذكر الناس دائما نفكر ان في الذكر باللسان, وهذا خطأ شائع. It's not about remember Allah by tongue. No, الذكر to remember. So التذكر, remembering is something in your heart. When I ask you, do you remember what happened last year? هل تتذكر ما حدث العام الماضي؟ I don't want you to talk. أنا لا أسألك عن شيء بلسانك, ولكن لأن قلبك مشغول بمن يحب فتذكره على لسانك. Because your heart is attached to the one you love, your tongue will start to mention his name. So نحن نحب الله سبحانه وتعالى ونذكره في قلوبنا, فتذكره إيه؟ ألسنتنا. So this is the main meaning. أن الله سبحانه وتعالى mentioned the منافقين ولا يذكرون الله إلا قليلا. The hypocrite one, those who remember Allah a little. So this is very good indication that when you remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى, this is an indication of good iman, increasing in the iman. وفي حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: مثل الذي يذكر ربه والذي لا يذكر ربه مثل الحي والميت. The one who remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى with his heart and with his tongue, with his mind, okay, his analogy like the living one and the dead one or dead person. So سبحان الله, الحي والميت. So big difference between the people who are alive and moving and those who are not. And there is many hadith, but there is no time to mention all of them. But also حضور مجالس الذكر, to attend any حلقة, any درس, to remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Whatever a lecture or some people reciting the Quran or making ذكر without بدعة, يعني without innovation in the deen. You make ذكر according to the sunnah of رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. وكان معاذ بن جبل يقول للرجل من إخواني: اجلس بنا نؤمن ساعة. يعني معاذ بن جبل used to tell his friends, see when we sit together we talk about البيت والسيارة والعمل, we talk about house, mortgage, the cars, the business. And they used to, when they said, to remember Allah سبحانه وتعالى, فيجلسان فيذكران الله سبحانه وتعالى ويحمدانه يحمداني سبحانه وتعالى. The third point, البعد عن المعاصي, to avoid sins. So this is very important. أن يتجنب الإنسان المعاصي والفتن and to avoid as much as we can any sins whatever major or minor as much as we can. الشاعر يقول خلي الذنوب صغيرها وكبيرها ذاك التقى واصنع كماش فوق أرض الشوك يحذر ما يرى لا تحقرن صغيرة إن الجبال من الحصى. Don't say this is little one because the big mountains made out of small rocks. And الحسن البصري has a beautiful statement or قول كان يشبه الكبيرة بالأسد يعني الوحش المفترس والصغائر بالذئاب ثعالب صغيرة أو ذئاب صغيرة. فيقول نحن نهرب من الأسد لنفاجئ بخمسين ذئب يفترسنا. يعني the analogy is the major sin like a lion and the minor sin like a wolf. And he said we used to run from the lion to find 50 wolves to eat us. So when we have too many sins, even minor ones, will destroy us too. So this is the third one. The fourth one, والرابعة الإكثار من النوافل والطاعات opposite يعني 3 and 4 are opposite. فas long as we يعني كلما اجتهدنا في الطاعات والنوافل ونستكثر من النوافل غير الفروض كالسنن صيام اثنين وخميس كل ما تستطيع كل ما هو زيادة ونفل تستطيع أن تقوم به هذا يزيد الإيمان. any extra act of worship that you do like fasting Monday and Thursday all the sunan after dhuhr before dhuhr after before asr and after maghrib what we do now tarawih is nawafil all this will help to increase the iman in our hearts and we the beautiful hadith الحديث الرائع عن رب العزة سبحانه وتعالى يقول وما يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وكنت بصره الذي يبصر به وكنت يده التي يبطش بها وكنت رجله التي يمشي بها ولئن سألني لأعطينا ولئن استعاذني لأعيذنا. So Allah سبحانه وتعالى in this beautiful hadith said that my slave is acting on nawafil more and more. The more you act on nawafil till Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves you. And the moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you, He will give you a hearing power from His power subhanahu wa ta'ala, a vision from His power subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you will gain even your hand, your leg, all of them when you walk, when you do any act, it will be amplified by the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever you seek, Allah will accept your dua. And whatever you seek refuge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from any bad evil by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from any evil, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you. So these are the ahadith or the some of the method. I'm not saying this everything. Okay? No, this is just, as again, our hints for fixing our aql and fixing our qalb. So we come to the practical part. What we do? We are the little ummah of Oakville. Most of the people who come to pray Jum'ah in this Friday and who come to pray Taraweeh with your right hand. So what do you do? We are ummah together, little ummah. Maybe you are maybe in Oakville 10,000 Muslim. So we can form this community of Oakville. So what we need to do every time we have someone come to this mic said we have a fundraising and we all don't like it. We don't like to do fundraising, but I want to do something else. I want to do ilm raising and iman raising. I want to form two groups. One group is responsible for al-ilm, how to provide ilm to our little ummah in Oakville. Whatever you communicate with the mashayikh, but we need mainly in the administration level and the people who go talk to other people, how we can form حلقات علم, مجالس علم, فيقبل عليها الناس ونتابعهم. Same with إيمان. كيف نتابع إيمان بعضنا البعض؟ النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الصحيح الإيمان بضع وسبعون شعبة وفي رواية بضع وستون شعبة أعلاها لا إله إلا الله وقول لا إله إلا الله وأدناها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق والحياء شعبة من الإيمان. رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith that الإيمان is 60 odd or 70 and odd numbers. So say 70 branches of إيمان. The highest one to clear, to declare from your heart لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. And the lowest one is to remove the harm from the people, path and ways. Okay? And حياء, modesty is branch of the iman. So just imagine if we have in this masjid with our little ummah, can we call it Dar family, Dar community, little ummah, Oakville ummah, whatever you call it. Don't worry about the names, you know. So we have every month or every week, we take one branch. We read about it, say 1 month. So we have an hour every week to learn the ilm, whatever fiqh and so and so. And we have another hour for iman. How we take this shu'bah, branch of the iman from Rasulullah sallam, and we read about it and implement it. So how to take the ideas of Islam into practical way. So today I'm asking for people to fund this, not by money, by your effort, by your talent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you knowledge, give you time, give you whatever talent Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give. وَمِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ يُنْفِقُونَ. From what we provided them, they spend. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you? How to serve the Muslim ummah, Muslim community in Oakville with increasing the ilm and increasing the iman. Who's willing to work in these two projects? I need names. I need someone to say, I will be dedicated to make a program and follow up with the mashayikh and call everybody and go and knock on the door. I don't need your money. No money. Don't worry. We want you. I don't want your money. I want you. So this is important, to follow up with each other. To worry about each other. To worry about iman, our iman. Because this is the road to Jannah. Who's willing to work in these two projects? Or we just sit and talk? No. MashaAllah, you said? Okay, one? We all? No. I'm serious. Because brother Ahmed Jalad, فين Ahmed? Ahmed كان هنا. Ahmed is writing the names for volunteers. Ahmed, no, Ahmed Sajid, Ahmed Jalad. So I'm serious, wallahi. I need names. Okay? There is no sense for what we are saying until we do it. You know what I love in English when they say, walk the talk? I love this, walk the talk, you know? Because this is the one major problem that we have with our Muslim ummah right now, that we just talk, but we don't take actions. So again, I want some people to work in, alhamdulillah, this month of Ramadan and maybe a few weeks before, we started the Waqf group, alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, and we are finalizing with the lawyers. Okay, we started the IT group for the Dar, that they work to solve all the IT issues in the masjid. We started Dar sport, so we can have good muscles, you know. And we have swimming, basketball, soccer, and they will have programs, inshallah, after Ramadan. What else we need to do? So we need these two things. Ilm group that take care about ilm, and we say for example, we take 5 years. 1 year we study aqidah, only aqidah for 1 year. Second year we study fiqh, only fiqh. Third year we study seerah. Fourth year tafsir. So within 5 years you will get the minimum knowledge to be a Muslim. There is minimum knowledge that we have to acquire. So, you know, we just grab something here, we drive and listen to a sheikh, and then you are not focusing 100%. فَإِحْنَا أَنْتَ لَسْتَ عَالِمْ وَلَسْتَ جَاهِلْ. You are not a scholar or ignorant. You are in the middle. And this is a big problem. Those who 50-50 will create a lot of confusion and problems. You want something? You want the mic? Yes.
You're done with the two, and now my turn fundraising.
I want you to think about it. Either we take courses, inshallah, we arrange with the mashayikh and the ulama to come, but we need people to come. There's no sense to bring the mashayikh and no one attend in the class, okay? And the other one with iman, because it's very important. We have this 70 branches of iman, and then every month, every week, whatever we agreed, whoever designed the program, that's 1 month we take imatatul ada an al-tariq. So, you know, you have a towing truck and keep removing the cars that parking in the neighbors, remove it away. Yes? Jazakallah khair. Anta, you will make the details. This is the issue. You know, you said, okay, no problem. Come with proposal. Think about it. Say, I work in the ilm project. I will search. I will come with, we'll make a team. Then 2, 3, 4, 5 brothers come together. Same with the sisters. And we form a committee or group, and this group will work on this. But this is very important because many people are falling either with the ilm or with the iman. So I will leave you with this, inshallah. But again, please, 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 salah wal islah will not start without actions, right? If we just talk about it, nothing will change. Ammu Ahab want to say something?
No, the cars, two cars.
When will it start?
When we started, if you are interested, I said Ahmed Jalad should take the names and the phone, email, or contact me, and inshallah I will group each group together, and then after Ramadan we start, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum.